here outside the Stenson Auditorium for the most anticipated LDM event of the semester. An evening dedicated to fashion and photography, followed by a screening of the documentary of the late Diana Vreeland, famous editor of Vogue magazine, all of which intend to showcase a new renaissance of Florentine beauty. In 1817, the French author Stendhal underwent the profoundest experience of ecstasy he ever had encountered when admiring the beauty of Florence. In a city like Florence, where you can experience beauty everywhere and at any time, how can one define beauty? In what ways does it continue to astonish and fascinate us? What place does beauty have in our everyday life? Thus, the theme of LDM's 2013 spring event, organized by the students of the course Event Planning, is Beauty, and the evening aims to reawaken the mystery of beauty by viewing it through the eyes of three fascinating female artists: photographer Lucilla Bellini, fashion designer Natalia Franco Cabrera, and Diana Vreeland, the famed fashion editor of Vogue magazine. The first of the three women, Lucilla Bellini, is actually a Florence native. She focuses on beauty through photography in an exhibit which she displays different images using closed eyes as a form of expression. From Colombia, but a resident in Florence, Natalie Franco Cabrera is one of the founders of Recycolo, an art project that uses secondhand clothing in the creation of unique dresses. On display is a robe mega dress with a pattern of a basket, which is said to have required a lot of precision, concentration, and technique to create. Ending off the night was the screening of a documentary, Diana Vreeland, The Eye Has to Travel, on the life and career of the late Diana Vreeland, former fashion editor of Vogue. She is said to have been one of the most enduring female icons of the 20th century, launching to fame figures like Twiggy and for advising Jack Onassis. We spoke to event planning professor Eva DeClark about the theme of the event.
I have chosen Lucilla Bellina and Natalia Franco Cabrera because Lucilla is a young photographer from Florence, and she has a studio here on the other side of the Arno. And Natalia Franco, she is a Colombian, but she's living in Florence for almost 8 years now. And she has a small shop on the other side of the Arno. She uses recycled clothes to make new, unique clothes. So I thought it was interesting to bring them together to propose this new idea of a renaissance and Florentine beauty. And Diana Vreeland, I've chosen her because it is a very interesting documentary on her life and especially on her career. She was an extraordinary woman. She was not what we consider normally a natural beauty, okay? But she has been a fashion icon. She has influenced a lot of famous people, and she has become even a legend herself in the end. So that's why I thought it was interesting to bring these three female artists together. So I have chosen beauty because this spring, Florence, there are a lot of things to do around beauty. There is also the exhibition at Strozzina, An Idea of Beauty. And there was also the artisan workshops at the Fortezza d'Abasso, which were the angels of beauty, the artisans. So I thought it was interesting that the students could help the city of Florence to reawake this idea of beauty.
Event planning student Anne Marie Liato told us about her experience.
I'd say we are pretty involved in the event. It's definitely a team effort. Our teacher, Eva, she was great. We couldn't have done it without her. But each of us did something separate. Like, some people brought the food here. I set up a PowerPoint. Yeah, everyone did a little bit of everything, which definitely, helped to bring, a good event together. So, yeah.
And what differences did you experience between maybe planning an event in America and one in Italy?
Surprisingly, it's kind of alike. Luckily, a lot of people speak English here in Florence, so it's been pretty easy, communicating and, getting with food and everything. It's been pretty easy. Probably in America, I'd say the advertisement has been pretty much the same. Because this city is a little bit more condensed, we can put posters and such on the walls and on the streets and everything. But besides that, I think it's pretty similar to America.
It's the same effect that the city of Florence and its beauty and culture has left on its LDM students this semester.